स्टूडेंट, टुडे विल स्टडी ऑफ क्लास 5 सब्जेक्ट मोरल साइंस। योर बुक नेम फ्रेंडशिप विद वैल्यूज। नाउ विल बी स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3 टाइटल इज द फ्रॉग एंड द प्लेक स्नेक। अबाउट द चैप्टर, इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न हाउ ए क्लेवर स्नेक ट्रैप्ड द फ्रॉग in his statements and ate all of them. Think and discuss. We should always be aware in the company of flatterers, otherwise we will have to suffer. Near a mountain there lived an old snake by the name of Black Mamba. One day he thought to himself, I am getting old to hunt for food. How could I manage to maintain myself without having to work hard for it? Then he hit upon a plan. He went to a pond that was full of frogs and began to behave as thought he had given up everything and renounced the world. A frog came out of the water and asked him, why are not you moving about in search of food as usual? Ah, replied the snake, unfortunate fellow that I no longer have any desire for food. I will explain to you. Last night when I was wandering about in search of food, I saw a frog. When I tried to catch him, he got frightened and jumped in among a group of Brahmins who were recording a holy book and vanished. I could not reach him there, so I sat waiting for him to come out. Meanwhile, any eyes fell on a Brahman, his son, and out of irritation, I beat him. He died on the spot. His father was heartbroken and he cursed me with these words, "Wicked demon of a serpent, you have beaten my son and killed him when I did nothing to you. For this, from today on you shall serve the frog and they will use you to ride on. You will live of whatever they are pleased to offer you." And so said the snake, "I have come to serve you." When the frog heard the snake's story, he went and told it to the others. Finally the king a frog came to know about this. He thought it very strange and visited the snake himself in the company of his minister in order to ascertain the facts. After the snake had assured him that his life would be safe, the king climbed on his back. Other frogs also took their turn according to the age, and those who the snake accepted to them various type of crawling. The king of the frog was delighted and he said, "I have never had so much pleasure riding on elephant, a horse, a carriage or a human being as by riding the snake. Next day the snake started crawling slowly on purpose. When the king noticed this, he asked him, "Friend, why are not you crawling as you usually do?" "I have had nothing to eat," replied the snake. "I am too weak to crawl properly." "So the frog killed," king replied. "All right then, you can eat small frog." When the snake heard this, he pretended to be surprised and said, "Well, well, well." This is certainly the second part of the Brahmin curse that has come true, for he said that I should have to live on whatever the frogs were pleased to offer me. Your majesty, your kindness makes me very happy." After that, the snake began to eat small frog daily, and in short time he became very strong. The snake thought to himself with a smile, I have beguiled them enough to allow me to eat the small frog. But how long will this supply last? The frog king was so completely taken in by the snake talks that he did not understand his real motive. After a few days, a big black snake came to the snake place. He was stunned to see frog riding on the snake, and he said to him, "My friend, those frogs are our food. Why are you carrying them on your back?" "It is beneath you. I do agree with you," said the first snake. "But I am playing a fool and waiting patiently. And he explained everything to the brown snake. One day the snake said with a laugh, "Eating all this frog, I have discovered different tastes." And the frog king, hearing this, was dumbfounded and said to the snake, My good fellow, what kind of talk is that? To cover up this sleep," the snake replied, "Oh, nothing at all." And then with his labor trap, he succeeded in putting the frog king at ease. In due course, the snake started eating even the larger frog, and in the end, he ate the frog king himself, and all the frog were utterly whipped out. Now complete your lesson. Moral of the story is, beware of deception from all quarters, including your friends. Now complete your lesson. Your homework is lesson 3.